And we're the voice of the people. We have to stand up for those children that are missing, the children that are being separated from the parents, and no separation of families. This shouldn't be happening. It should not be happening. And it's not right. And when it's not right, you have to stand up for it. You can't stand up. There's nothing else we can do. Stand up and say it's wrong. It's gone on too long.
So, you know, rallies like these around the country might not change the tempo of the administration, obviously, but we hope to accomplish here.
Hoping that, that it'll put pressure on the government, that people will take conscience and they'll realize that this is wrong, it's going on, it's wrong. I met up with some people that didn't even know that there was children missing on the border, being separated from parents, and then children being in cages, that's not right. Trump calling us animals, that's not right. There's a lot of things, you know, we're not criminals. Most of the people are here to work, and they get back to the community.
And why do you think the issue of immigration is so important to Salinas in particular?
We have been fighting for the immigration reform with the UFW and all the... It's a working community, and we've been trying to get the reform for immigration and a comprehensive reform, but it stopped, and now we're starting to try and get back up again, you know, so that's what we want to do. We want to get immigration reform, and it needs to be done now, but that stopped, and asylum for the people that need it.
Okay, anything else you want to add?
No, we can do it. It's a play.
Hi, my name is Vianney Fuentes. V-I-E-N-A-Y, F-U-E-N-T-E-Z.
Okay, you know, my thought when I first came out here is it's a celebratory, it's not a protest.
It's a protest, yes. We're here protesting the illegal separation of children from families. It's illegal, inhumane, and we just want to let our brothers and sisters know that we're here to support them, and we want to let the government know that we're not going to stay quiet, and we're against all of this.
So how does it make you feel, maybe, when you see some of the videos that are now coming in from regards to some of the children being kept in Brownsville shelter that used to be Walmart laws?
It hurts me, it angers me, and it brings tears to my eyes. These children are being traumatized. So are their parents. Their parents don't know what's going on. They don't know where they're being taken. They're being told, oh, we're going to go wash them up, do this, that, and the other, and then they never see them again. I've also seen videos of children on trial, alone, representing themselves. It's ridiculous. We're not going to stay quiet.
The Trump administration and Attorney General Jeff Sessions says it's a deterrent to stop people from coming into the country illegally. Like, this is what will happen, as a way of saying, what do you say to maybe that kind of an argument?
Well, you know what, honestly, in all honesty, it is, you know, I'm pretty sure there are families that are not going to be coming because of that, but it's still illegal and it's still inhumane. It's a crime against, you know, humanity. You cannot be doing that to children.
Anything else you want to add, anything important about being here today?
Yeah, I want to say, it's wrong. It's wrong. We're not going to stay quiet. No border, no deportation, no illegal separation. We're not going to stay quiet.
Real quick, on that no border, I'm just going to push back a little bit. Should there be no border between U.S. and Mexico?
You know what? If there's going to be a border between the U.S. and Mexico, then the U.S. needs to stop. We're going to have to cut.
We ended everything.
Okay. They're going to have to stop exploiting our people. Because the U.S. doesn't want them coming, but they want them picking their crops. The U.S. wants them cooking their food. The U.S. wants to celebrate their holidays. The U.S. wants to be, you know, listening to their music and portraying that they're all, you know, they're all for Mexicans. But at the end of the day, what are they doing? They're separating families and they're treating them inhumanely. Particularly about maybe how this seems like a
the one behind the sign.
Across the island.
Yeah.
It should be, at least you think it should be a no-brainer.
It is a no-brainer. It's a total no-brainer. I mean, we've stood here and, you know, the Trump supporters are standing on this corner and, you know, go to work and we come home and we see them and people are shaking their heads because it's so confusing today with the current administration. But here it is with young people being separated from their parents. A friend over here was just saying that her daughter has a one-year-old, and she asked her, what would it be like if somebody took your one-year-old baby? You know, an American citizen has your child removed. I mean, it's insane. So America is for family values, cuts both ways here. You know, this is the Republican slogan, but we're mostly Democrats standing here, and we can unify on this. And so the Catholic Church has come behind this, evangelical churches are coming behind this, the Democrats, I mean, the Speaker of the House is behind this. So why can't they do something about this?
What would you think is the policy prescription? Because, as I asked her before, I'm just giving you the other side of the argument. Attorney General Jeff Sessions says this is to deter illegal immigration. Is that a good enough argument? Does that square away in your mind?
I think there are less dramatic ways than this. This is cruel. This is immoral. And I think that's what's unifying us. And so when we see somebody who uses these kinds of tactics, we say no. That's all. And there were more people honking at us. I don't know how it happened. You know, I mean, the majority of the people that are coming by are honking. They're honking for this. Why is that? Because we've had enough. We've had enough of immorality. And, you know, they were calling people coming for asylum in the same vein as illegals. But there's a big difference between people who are coming here for good reason that they just don't want to come here for a better job. And I would say let those people in too, but this is a deeper meaning about, and it's a deeper it shows us a deeper side of what we're made of. You know, is this America? Do you want to live here when we're doing that? So that's why all these people are coming out today. So I don't know what else to say. Ask me a question.
No, that's perfect. Actually, you're really well spoken. I'm going to use a good part of that, especially the part when you say honking and people start honking.
I think
that was really good. I didn't get your name.
My name is Jeff Dubin. I live here in South Salinas. I'm a homeowner, taxpayer, and retired guy.
D-U-B-I-N?
D-U-B-I-N.
Double F on the Jeff, right?
Yes, that's it.
Okay, thanks, Jeff.
Okay.
I appreciate it.
Okay, your name is?
Christopher.
Nice to meet you.
There you go.
Okay.
Thank you.
We should separate children from
the community.
Right.
I've said this a thousand times. No, this is important.
There you
What's
go.
Going on in
here? We're getting something here. Or
maybe last
we're
night.
Getting
I
can hear you.
You
don't find often that somebody comes to a rally and whoops, that's in a car.
Do
you want to do it here?
We can do it here with the people. But quick question. How will I be presented? Because you know how this stuff is. Or how, explain what's going to happen. And
how do you want to do it?
No, I'm saying. Oh, I've
been recording.
Oh,
just been rolling.
I have been rolling. Yeah. But if there's anything in there you don't want me to put, that's fine.
It is a public space, so.
Yeah. No, I know, but I'm just saying because on the record.
I get what you're saying. I know what you're saying.
No, he's not going to misconstrue you. Or at least this guy won't.
Yeah. Right. And that's the thing, because on the record, I'm not like a full-on Trump supporter.
I agree with some of them, and I disagree with a lot. You know, it's just,
I won't fully outright hate someone, but I won't fully outright disagree. Because there are some things, you know, there's compromise.
And I think every president, I think the opposite.
Yeah, exactly. And I feel like as a democratic society, we have to compromise. Compromise is the art.
We had it all, so don't worry.
Well, you know, I decided to come out here just to give people an idea.
He's only one man here.
I don't care where you're from.
Remember that. There are 30 of us here.
That is
well, I've talked to everybody.
He's doing good.
I came here just to speak, you know, with everyone. You know, they're my fellow Americans. They're my countrymen. And I feel like compromise is all people need. The more we come together and the more we speak on these issues, and the more we're overall able to just speak on things, because too much of at each other's, we've been at each other's throats for so long in this country. People have been disagreeing, I mean, without compromise, people have been disagreeing without talking it out. And yes, I agree with a lot of what they're saying, and at the same time, I disagree with a couple of things, but overall, I feel like the more we talk it out, the more we learn to come to terms with what's going on, and the more likely they are to take proper actions and change. Because right now, they're doing a great thing. They're fulfilling their roles as American citizens, and they're, you know, addressing a problem that, of course, needs to be fixed, because it's not fair that, you know, children are being separated from their families. It's horrible. It's a dark time in American history. But like everything in American history, there are dark times. We need a rough through these and we need to fix them. Because our job as American citizens is to prevent this from ever happening again.
Real quick here, Republican,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, there's a lot of us out here.
Yeah. Okay. What's your name, by the way?
Boronda.
I don't know.
Okay,
we gotta get ready for our hit. Yeah, we're gonna do something. Alright, thank you.
Thank you. childhood.
What?
I don't know.
Okay.
Yeah, I guess Steve's usually the one to blame. But
by the way, I'm leaving early to go to Traffic and Transportation Committee.
Oh, well, how's that going to work out?
Well, public comments are going to be fun.
Why?
Because the asshole chair wouldn't let me comment on the last agenda item. So this is the second time I've been allowed to say something. I'm having fun embarrassing
as much as
I can.
So, yeah, this is
the
second
rock.
Which one is that?
The chair. What's his name? Larry Cat.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he ran.
He's a Salinas resident.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, good for him.
So, yeah. Well, I'm not sure exactly what I'm going to say. I might have some fun.
Talk about the traffic signals, how the signals need to get updated so a whole stream of cars can get through there. Because they want to do red light cameras, but they don't care about this. And this should be part of that planning.
I think this is the county intersection. I'm not sure, but I think it is.
Well, every city intersection ought to have.
This is part of the problem. It depends who's responsible for it, if they care.
That's the heinous crime. It's not a crime because that's
after
politics.
After the next song, we're going to do the democracy chant, you know?
Okay.
You know what it is?
No.
What?
This is what the WFC looks like?
It's like, yeah, but what's that? What's the question?
Tell me what
democracy looks like. This is what democracy looks like.
Well, having a hold of the microphone would have been better.
But they probably already know that.
a little tiny truck that did that. It's not that tiny, but... Right on. Right on, man. Where's the children?
Thank you.
eating breastfeeding, yeah. Well, there's money to be made. Contracts to be signed and people to make money off of. Thank you. Glad to see some familiar faces. Getting your chords together. They don't want to hear from me. This school's VW. The last thing they want to do is give me any kind of
But that's why you should. That's why you should talk to prepare some of the kids want to say something.
Right. Are the kids willing to say yes? Awesome. Awesome. That's even better.
That's what's needed. It's straight from the heart.
Yeah. How would
Thank you.
ribbon of bondage. I saw a body that endless childbed. I saw he loved me.
That's
all in
that. I
share
the mic.
Well, it's fine, actually, because, you know, if you're a guitar, you don't want to be vocal, though, you know. Yeah, it's pretty good. Oh, yeah.
This is better than that.
Yeah.
You girl, you dumb girl.
Get inside. You get it? You get it?
Oh, gosh. That's too much of a flash,
no deportation, no illegal separation.
All right, we didn't cross the border. The border crossed us.
In the desert and all around me,
what are you looking at, like 6:05 or so, or what are you looking at, 6:10?
Us?
Yeah, it's 5:59, you're going live, right?
Yeah, we're just meeting stuff now. We're at the other protest on North Main.
Yeah, how's that?
There wasn't as many people as this one.
Seriously?
Yeah, that's why we came back here.
Oh, wow, okay.
Yeah, so, we'll see. We're going to climb now, though. We got to hurry.
Yep, yep. I just hope you got enough cord. Did you want, because I picked a couple people if they wanted to talk, or are you just going to talk
when you're talking? No, right after. Yeah, I'll grab them right when we're done with them.
Okay. Okay, so who wants to talk on the news today? Right after they do a live thing, they'll want to do something. So think about what you might want to say. Come from the heart, dude. Okay, remember it's serious, so we don't want to do too much goofing off. We want to be serious, so this is real business.
Yeah, you don't want to be awkward. You don't want the I love to be awkward.
Right. Well, it's serious business. What if it was your brother or sister?
Then I would try to cheer them up if they're kind of scared.
You're going to need a lot of cheering up, that's for sure.
Thank you.
doing a live feed. He's going to do a live feed and then,
been light of mine. I'm going to light of mine. I'm going to let it shine.
Well, I guess we only get out of the shot.
Let it shine, let it shine.
They probably use battery if they don't because they're more rambunctious.
Maybe
your mother got it right here, or your mother something right here.
Well, I'm trying to get her, but I'll talk to her.
Because she seems real strong.
Oh, she is. She's got to be.
South Salinas at the corner of Main and Blanco, and as you can see, there's another rally happening. That one is at Main and Boronda. There's also a rally in Watsonville, Greenfield, and Inhumane. Now, when you look at this rally, it feels celebratory. There's people singing, there's cars that are honking as they arrive, signs, making chants of various kinds, but make no mistake about it, they are protesting the Trump administration. Zero tolerance policy when it comes to people illegally. In those cases, when parents are caught and charged, they end up in jail and their children are separated, rendered unaccompanied. Judge Sessions has called the policy necessary to deter people from crossing the border illegally, but I can tell you, rally goers here in Salinas are not buying that argument. And they call the administration's practices, quote, inhumane. Now more and more people people are starting to arrive here as I speak to you. This weekend is scheduled to last until 6:30, but I got to imagine it's going to last even longer than that. I will have another hit for you coming up in 30 minutes. For now, reporting in Salinas, I'm Christopher Salas, KSBW Action News 8. Made it.
Right, right as we were driving by, I think somebody said boo.
Really?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, oh well.
Well, I only have one person, as I was in the median there, somebody rode by and they said, fuck the children.
Congregating. Okay. safe. Is that the protest meeting today?
He did agree that it wasn't okay for them kids to be taken away from their parents. He did say that.
Yeah. No. They agree on the issue. However, they agree on some of the policy.
You know what? There's people, and we're
strong. But he still wants to see all the gangsters go. He wants to see anybody who's committed a violent felony or the criminals. You also heard about this community meeting coming up on next Monday?
No.
So this will be and if this RV ban goes through the next day, then we'll be at City Hall the next day. But hopefully this is with Bavera. Hopefully Steve McShane will show up.
Okay.
Because he's the maker of the ordinance.
Oh, the oversized vehicles. Yeah. It's a big deal.
So the community meeting on Monday at 6 at City Hall, and then Tuesday at City Council. Hopefully they drop it to me.
Malvado.
Son muy pocos que ofrendan su vida. Quedan que ver por sus paisanos.
You want to talk to anybody?
Que puedan los héroes con batallas su vida dejaron para que el hombre de México muera.
Well, you say you got someone from North Bay already.
Oh, yeah,
okay, alright.
Ricardo from the UFW. And,
okay.
Ahora ya me despido, paisano.
Okay, who else?
No
te ofendas por lo que te canto.
Debbie, maybe?
Se te hierve la sangre en las venas. Es porque eres también mexicano. Pero aplica
tu furia. There was like a little blip out. Help, help, Southside needs help. And so glad to be
here. Explota y humilla tu hermano.
Oh, you're kidding!
No se falta que vuelvan los héroes. En batalla su vida dejaron.
A
que el hombre de México fuera libre y digno de ser respetado.
Go strong, Sebi. You might want to go home. This is Sebi. You might go home yet. See, and those guys are having the quite a debate over there. Might be interesting to listen to these. I want to get here, but you know, I'm just really comfortable. You know, they're hopefully doing a healthy dialogue.
I think they're done with the interview.
Marcy's, I mean, just put them right there in the stack.
Thank you for coming.
Where are they?
So, there was only about maybe six negative comments. About 300 or 400 honks, man, and a lot more as it gets later.